Alright, now let's go on to the region settings. These settings determine which portion of the screen will be recorded. Before I go into this, it is important to note that some resolutions will not work with certain codecs. So to be on the safe side, for your video's resolution, I recommend making sure that both the width and height values are divisible by 4 without leaving any remainder. For example, a 640 width by a 480 height. 640 divided by 4 equals 180. 480 divided by 4 equals 120. This is instead of, say, something like 630 for the width by 410 for the height. 630 divided by 4 equals 157.5, or 157 with a remainder of 2. 410 divided by 4 equals 102.5. I don't recommend using values like these. For this video you're watching now, I used a width of 640 and a height of 360. As you can see, both of these values are divisible by 4. Going back to the region options, you'll notice that the first option you can choose here is, well, region. What this lets you do is select which area you're going to record using a dropper. So basically, once you click record, just click and drag with the mouse to draw out which area you want to be capturing. If you notice, CamStudio will display info about your recording area above the cursor as you're dragging out the selection rectangle, including how far the top left corner of the selection area is from the top left corner of the computer screen, as well as the recording area's width and height values in pixels. Now, as soon as you let go of the left mouse button, the record starts. Note, when you're using a region option other than full screen, CamStudio will use 4 green markers to show you the boundaries of the recorded area. These 4 green markers can be dragged around using the mouse cursor to change which area you are recording. Although I find things a little bit difficult, as once you start dragging with the mouse, you have no idea exactly what you're going to be recording until you let go. The next option is fixed region. This allows you to use a predefined resolution for your capture area. With this option enabled, once you start recording, the region size you set will be represented by a rectangle attached to your cursor. When you click with the left mouse button, CamStudio will set the capture area at the place you clicked. If you're not sure about the size and location of the capture area, you can draw it out by clicking the select button inside the fixed region panel, similar to when you're using the region setting mentioned earlier. You can also use the fixed top left corner option to have CamStudio always record the same portion of the screen, based on how many pixels you want it from the left and how many pixels you want it from the top. You can see there's also the option to disable your ability to drag the corners of the capture area when CamStudio is recording. If you unclick this option and then hit record, you won't be able to drag any of these 4 green corners representing the capture area. You notice when you hover the cursor over them, it stays a cursor. Whereas if you have drag corners to pan enabled, the cursor becomes the 4-pointed arrow when you hover it over one of the corners. The next region option is window. This option was added in CamStudio 2.5. What this option does is set the recording area to the size and location of the next window you click on once you start the recording. Now, in CamStudio, or at least CamStudio 2.5, this option is a bit buggy and sometimes removes a line of pixels from the bottom and from the right of your recording area once you're done recording. It may also set your capture area to a resolution not divisible by 4. I recommend that you actually don't use this option for those reasons. The last region option is full screen. What this option does is pretty self-explanatory. It sets the recording area to be your entire computer screen or entire desktop once you hit the record button. Just keep in mind that when you're choosing a region size, the larger the region you record, the larger your video's file size will be. As for myself, I usually use the fixed region option with the fixed top left corner option checked. And I don't usually use width and height settings like these. I usually use one of these settings, especially if I plan on uploading the video to somewhere like YouTube, Vimeo, or MetaCafe. The last setting I'm going to cover in this tutorial is autopan. You can enable it through the options menu right here. This causes the recorded area to follow or chase the cursor, rather than simply stay at a fixed position. For example, You can adjust CamStudio's tracking speed with the option autopan speed. As you can see, it's set to 20 by default. You can lower or raise it by dragging the track bar slider. Here's 10, 50, and 100. You get the idea. You can turn it on or off by going through the options menu while recording and checking or unchecking the enable autopan option. Autopan works with all region settings except full screen. And it will override the fixed top left corner setting in the fixed region option. One thing to note here is, with many video codecs, using this option can greatly increase your video's file size, as there will be less like or similar frames next to each other in your video for your encoder to merge together or get rid of. Another thing to note here with autopan is, unless you're capturing at full screen, by default CamStudio will attempt to draw a rectangular outline around the area you're capturing, similar to the four green brackets that are drawn when autopan is disabled. I don't know if you can see it in this video, but there's a little rectangle following the cursor around. Sometimes it will show up inside the recording. You can turn off the capture area highlighter by going to Options, Program Options, Hide Flashing Rectangle During Recording, and then clicking on this. The downside to having this option enabled is you won't have any visual indication as to what area CamStudio is actually capturing. Anyways, this is all the settings I wanted to cover in this tutorial. I hope you found it somewhat helpful.